Hello beautiful falls, it's again Ashish from Ashfield Creations and welcome back guys. So today we are going to create an amazing photo manipulation just like Tony Mafood, kind of moody, dark theme, brownish theme. So first of all select the photo and with the help of select subject or you can use the quick selection tool and also guys you can use the quick pen tool to select very precisely the subject. Because it really guys take a lot of time to select the model or the subject. You can take your own time and just select very precisely. Now add a background to the photograph. So just download this background from the link in the description. And also guys just download the preset which I'm gonna be using in this particular photo editing. So you can also download that preset in the form of Camera Op, Mobile Lightroom, DNG or Lightroom preset for your desktop. All the links will be down given in the description, right? So you can just download it for free. Now just press control from the keyboard and just crop the button and crop the photo. And now the next thing we are gonna be fixing is that the really little bit of fringe on the hairs we're gonna be erasing with the help of eraser. Now just go to the liquify and we're gonna fix the hairs because I just want a little bit of adjustment on my hairs. So just increase the size of the brush and just stretch it a little bit from the forward and let's just make a little bit smaller from the back side. So you can see the preview before and after. This one is looking kind of cool. So we have fixed some of the adjustment. So this is also guys and totally up to you. If you're really satisfied with your hairstyle, you can totally skip this step. Now let's create a new layer. Select the square marquee tool and fill it with the 50% gray. Here we're gonna be doing the dodging and burning, that creating a jawlines in the photo. So this is very important guys. So you have to very keenly see the steps and do this process. Select the soft run brush and make sure selected the exposure to around 35 or 37 would be pretty perfect and just paint in the direction where you want to create a dodge. So we have selected the dodge tool and here a little bit of 10% we have created of the dodge reduced and a little bit do it on the nose area to get a perfect keen shape kind of pointed nose just like Tony Mafood. So here you can see the before and after. This one is literally looking so pretty perfect. You can still more reduce some of the opacity because we don't want to be look very unreal. So now select the blur tool and make the strength to 100% and make sure you have selected the soft run brush and just blur on the edges of the model because this is very important because in order to create a more realistic look so no one able to be and identify whether you have made a cutout or not. So it is very important to do the blurring process whenever you cut any of the subject. So you can just do the blurring process. Now just merge both the layer and crop once again. Just go to the filter, select the camera filter and here the real thing start guys, the process of color grading just like Tony Mafood. So here let me take the preset that is a John Carroll inspired preset. So you can just download this preset from the link in the description. As you can see this photo is looking very similar to this preset. So we're gonna still more fixing after applying the preset. So just go to the color and select the red tone and just increase the luminescence from the face because we want to brighten up the skin. So you can just a little bit increase the saturation and hue of the red and orange zone because it is very important for our skin structure to maintain. So we are doing this process, increase the luminescence and until you are satisfied with the tone you can just keep it. And now we're gonna still more do the adjustment on our basics. So select the basic and here we're gonna fix a little bit, increase the exposure of the photograph so that it may look kind of more perfect skin. Decrease a little bit of contrast and just decrease some of the highlights. As you can see highlight is also now here we're gonna increase a little bit of shadows because we want to maintain or get that black details of the outfits. So we're gonna be increasing a little bit of shadows, just more increase some of the exposure and increase some of the whiteness, just a bit would be pretty perfect and here also the blackness we gonna be decreasing a little bit, just a bit would be pretty fine. Alright, now this one seems to be kind of cool, I guess. So here is the color effect of that, and here is our Tony Ma photo. Just decrease a little bit of clarity to 10%. So here you can see the photo, and this is our photo. Just increase a bit of vibrance if you need. Now let's go to the curve and just decrease some of the matteness from the photo, because it was totally so matty. So we're gonna reduce some of the matteness and just hit OK. So as you can see, this before and after has literally changed the way of, you know, editing. Now we are getting very closer color effect like Tony Mahfood. Now just go to the hue or saturation, pick the skin tone that would be a red tone, and just make it to +7, because we want to make a goldish kind of skin tone. So we are making the turning the red from red to orange or kind of gold. Now just merge both the layer, go to the selective color, select the black color, and just select the cyan to 1%, magenta to +2, or 1 would be pretty perfect, +1 or +2 would be pretty perfect. And we're gonna be yellow to -1, and a little bit of black matte. So we're gonna be making more black, more darker. So just make a +1 of the black tone, +1 or +2. Yeah, we're gonna be making +1. So you can see the before and after. We have perfectly gained the color effect of Tony Mahfood, guys. Now just merge both the layers, and here the next process start, that is of, you know, making a real dodge and burn. So just duplicate the layer and rename it as a dodge, change the blending mode to screen, just right click on it and select the blending options, just move the slider from left to right all the way, just duplicate the layer. And we're gonna be naming or and place it on top of all the layer, and just change the blending mode to multiply. Just right click on it and select the blending options, press Alt key, and just move the slider from left to right until you get a perfect, you know, the keenly kind of, you know, effect as shown in the video. Let me just see more difference. You can totally, you know, play with, by pressing the Alt key, you can just play with this third that slider which comes out, that is a gradiented slider that will come out by pressing the Alt key. Now just more make a group of both the layer, add a layer mask on it, select the image and select the apply image. Now here it is important to select the layer that would be our original layer. So select that layer, and here you can see the before and after, guys. This one seems to be very, very perfect. The perfectly dodge and burn thing we have done. So now just merge both the layers. Still, you can just play with the blending options according to your convenience. Whatever kind of want, you can just play with it. Now just drag and drop this overlay. I'll put this overlay also in the link in the description. Now you can just place it over here to create a kind of, you know, backlight effect to the photograph. So as you can see, we have made or placed it and merged all the layers, so you can see the before and after. I hope you all have enjoyed this preset or the video. If you enjoyed, then just smash the like button, so it will motivate me to make cool videos and presets like this for you guys for free. And if you still not subscribed yet, then kindly do subscribe and follow me on Instagram, just type Ashfield Creations. And just visit my website www.ashfieldcreations.com and download all the presets and stuff just for free. So guys, see you in the next tutorial.